The British Fencing National Academy puts the fencer at the heart of what we do. It provides a structure to support and develop everybody within our sport, with the aim of creating great athletes.
My name's Linda Strachan, and my primary role here is as the lead academy coach, and my objectives for today are to ensure that one, that the group understand what we're trying to do as part of the academy, and it's also to coordinate the work of the three coaches, lead coaches here today, and that's Foyle, Epe and Sable, with Pierre, Sue and Ian, and to make sure that timetable flows. And the objectives outside of today, obviously, are to make sure that the group of fencers that we're working with in the academy, we follow the long-term athlete development model with them, and to ensure that we help them progress up to 2016 and beyond.
I'm Gabby Houseman, I'm from Oxford, and at the moment I'm 12th in the rankings for Great Britain, and I hope to improve that in the future. The key areas I'd like to improve today would probably be fitness and sparring against people that I don't get to fence on a regular basis, and just to learn more about my own fencing and to improve my own ability.
My name is John Richardson. I'm here with my friend Phil Marshall. We're here for strength and conditioning. That's our remit for the day. And what we're looking at essentially is, because fencing is such a one-side dominant sport, when it comes to the strength and conditioning, that can create problems further down the line with providing training programs to enhance the right leg lunge for the right fencer or the left leg lunge for the left-handed fencer. And we need to make sure that there's a level of balance within the musculoskeletal system, that the body is relatively balanced, and that will enable the fencers to produce longer training spells without injury and develop their skills and improve their outcomes then.
Hey, I'm Fola, I'm from Newcastle, and I'm 12th on the rankings. And today, I think I'm going to get out of this training day is that I'm going to learn a bit more about my sport, a bit more about myself and how I'm going to train, and how that's going to impact my future in fencing.
Hi, I'm Ian Williams, lead sabre coach for the National Cadet Academy, and I'm here today. It's the first session of the National Academy. For me, actually, this session is an opportunity to get to know the fencers a little bit better. Obviously, I do know all of them, but it's very much a case of, you know, getting to know them and also getting to know their strengths and weaknesses as a fencer.
My name is Gianfranco Artesi. I come from London and I fence sabre. Today I'm going to learn some new training regimes and hope to use them to improve my fencing for the future.
My name's Norman Randall. I'm the Director of Coach Education and Management for England Fencing. I'm also the Project Officer for British Fencing for Coach Education and Schools Fencing. My involvement in the National Academy is as one of the lead tutors alongside David Kirby. The aim for the day was largely to meet and greet the people on the programme. That is to say the students and the teaching staff, the directing staff who've been assigned to work with the coaches who are studying for their Level 3 and Level 4. So we built the day around introductory exercises where we could get to know each other, build the team, and also to get an opportunity really to see the coach cohort at work in the sal with a student or with each other, just to get a feel for where they were with their personal performance as well as with their coaching skills.
I'm George Hendry and I'm from Midhurst. I'm 8th in the cadets at the moment and 15th in the juniors. Today's going to be good for me to get out of fencing new people, new warm-up techniques, also the fitness aspect and the nutrition. I think I need to work on that, I think.
I'm Saskia Blair. I work as a physiotherapist for the British Fencing Association. Today in the Academy Training Day, we're looking at core stability for performance enhancement and also for prevention of injuries. We're focusing in on three key areas. We're looking at shoulder stability, pelvic stability and abdominals, specifically transverse abdominals. In fencing, we see a lot of neck and back injuries, most of them due to poor control around the shoulder and pelvic region. Specifically today, we're looking at exercises called the wall press, aiming to get stability around the shoulder to prevent shoulder and neck injuries, but also to enhance the fencing by increasing the fencer's reach, specifically towards the end of DEs as they fatigue.
My name's Chris Forbes, and I'm already a level 3 coach. I've come on the course to develop into a level 4 coach. So this is sort of a real starting point for the next sort of stage of development, really. So it's been a bit of an eye opener. There's certainly a lot to work on, but today has already been like hugely beneficial. We've just been saying in the group that there's been a huge amount of expert knowledge on hand, and everyone's really, really been like open and helpful with it. So any questions we've got, there's sort of two or three experts like within, you know, arm's reach to sort of help you get through things. So that's been brilliant.
Hi, I'm Sue Benny. I'm here as lead coach for the EPE. Hopefully it will benefit all the fencers here and the coaches, because when we take fencers abroad at the moment, we may never have seen them before. If we can work with them first at the academy, we all know they're going to have a certain technical knowledge. And so when we tell them something on the piece, they know what we're talking about.
I'm Dr. Jonathan Katz, a sports psychologist at the National Academy for British Fencing. And my main objective here is to work with the young fencers of ages about 13 to 16, 17 within the context of their long-term athlete development, particularly in learning how to train. Consequently, the main objectives are to increase self-awareness regarding what the demands are of training, and appreciating their need to become increasingly self-responsible with good discipline in terms of how they plan and implement their training with regard to their performance.
I'm David Kirby. I'm the lead tutor for the National Academy Coach Development Programme. We've just started day one of our 6 to 7 month programme to produce level 4 coaches, that's the top level national coaches, for the fencers of the future. There's a clear aim here that we want the coaches who can produce the fencers who will stand on the podium of the Olympics. We have managed to get together the sports scientists so that they can train the coaches in their specialisms, so that the coaches then have an understanding of firstly how to use the sports science specialists and what they're about, and secondly, employ those scientific skills in their coaching to produce better training, more effective training, better fencers, more effective fencers, and of course, more successful fencers.
Hi, I'm Justine Wilmot. I'm performance manager for the British Disabled Fencing Association, and I work with wheelchair fencing, which is a Paralympic sport. As we've got the rare opportunity of a home Olympics and Paralympics in London 2012, we're really trying to fast-track our fencers, wheelchair fencers, for that. And as part of that process, as we get more wheelchair fencers in the system, we're going to need increasingly more coaches to work with those fencers. And at the moment, the level, you know, the numbers of coaches that we have in the system aren't enough. And I think it's important that more coaches raise their awareness of wheelchair fencing. It's a very exciting sport. The able-bodied fencers can benefit from fencing against wheelchair fencers. And, you know, in terms of the sport, the more coaches we have engaged, the better it is, the better quality fencers we'll get come out in London 2012 and beyond.
I'm Jack Botler. I'm the British Fencing Young Official Development Officer. And I'm here at the Academy this week to oversee the refereeing and armoury programmes that will be going on. People get involved in volunteering in British fencing in a number of ways. They either as officials at competitions, for example, armourers, referees, or competition organisers or peace assistants. As assistants, doing things like helping out with catering, check-in, a number of different opportunities. So the events coming up in the future where volunteers will be required, there are the regular events that happen each season, for example, all the myriad of British championships, the women's sabre England Trophy World Cup, the Leon Paul and Eden Cups, foil A grades. Then, of course, in 2011 in Sheffield, British Fencing are going to be hosting the European Championships, and 2012 in London, the Olympic Games, which will be two once-in-a-lifetime opportunities for people to get involved in volunteering and have a really phenomenal experience.
In 10 years' time, I think I'll be world champion, Sabre. Yep.